The National Council on Public Transportation has, for a long time, been striving to implement a cashless system for commuters island-wide. But the tug of war appears to be amongst the minibus drivers themselves. While some say they need their cash in hand, others say that only some individuals will be the ones benefiting from this initiative. But the public relations officer for the Lakleri Minibus Association thinks the initiative is a good one.
I really believe, well, it is something that we need to undertake, you know. For too long, our minibus drivers have been attacked. Some of them have also lost their lives, you know, and, you know, we've been talking about that cashless initiative, you know, and I really believe we need to really look to implement it. Just last week, we had one of our colleagues there who got attacked in the Mondido area, you know, and just that incident can show well where we really need, because what the attackers, what they're really looking for is money, you know, and, you know, we need to really give it a try. A lot of our drivers, they are opposed to it, you know, but, you know, we need to adapt to change. You know, things are changing around us, you know, and we need to adapt to change. You cannot operate the same way you used to operate 15, 20 years ago, you know. These criminals, they are strategizing.
Mr. Eugene says the perpetrators who make it their duty to attack bus drivers are also observant, especially this Christmas season, and he wants his fellow operators to be aware of those who prey on them.
Again, you know, yes, we want to make money. We want to make as much money as possible, but then, you know, we need to be aware that those criminals, they are targeting us, they are observing the way we operate and things. You know, there are one or two things I really want to encourage our operators to do. One of them is, you know, when you arrive at the bus stand, do not leave your vehicles, the doors open, the windows open. You know, at least lock your windows, lock your doors, lock your windows until you are ready, you know, for first peg. You know, when you get to first peg, then you can reopen your vehicle. You know, there are times where people come and they just offer you a trip. For example, you operate in the Lakleri area, but for some reason or the other, somebody might just offer you a trip to go, let's say, for argument's sake, say, Marigot. You know, for me, it's like, why you didn't give somebody who's operating in the Marigot area a trip instead of a Lakleri? And sometimes we don't even know the person, you know. So we need to be aware of these things. Also, people will come to you and they will ask you to change monies for them. They will tell you, you know, ask you to change $100 for them just to see how much money you have in your pocket, you know. And sometimes, you know, absent-mindedly, we might just show off a pile of money, you know, and then you become a target right away.
The public relations officer for the Lakleri Minibus Association says that in many ways the initiative of the cashless system is one that can save lives. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.